Yo, what's up guys? Sam here. So every year the new iPhones come out, I hear this similar sentiment. Less so this year than last year or the year before, but it's something along the lines of all the iPhones this year are too big and I don't want to pay a ton of money. I just want to get a new iPhone SE with updated internals and call it a day, and I'll pay Apple like $400 or $500 for this device. I think this is a very vocal minority that feels this minority, not minority, that sounds kind of dirty. I think it's a very small group of people that feel this way, but I definitely think that there is some merit to this point. And apparently in the first quarter of 2020, Apple could be bringing back the iPhone SE, but just in a much different way than they did it traditionally. I want to give you guys the latest rumors, talk about this fresh report today. If you're excited for that, drop a like down below. And of course, hit subscribe so you stay up to date on all the latest Apple news. So iPhone SE rumors have been all over the place. I don't think there's any secret to that. We thought it was coming for sure in 2017 and definitely in 2018. There's even been evidence inside of Xcode for like a year now that Apple has been working on an updated lower cost iPhone. But to this day, nothing has happened. No new phone has been released, no new side project has been announced or rumored. It's honestly been pretty quiet until recently. A few months ago, we heard initially Apple could be working on something. And today, well-respected analyst Minji Ko has now put his bets, and these are big bets, on the return of an iPhone SE, but in a much different form. Rather than Apple going back to that coveted, that nostalgic iPhone 5 or iPhone 5S design, it's not gonna look anything like this. Apple's gonna be doing the same thing that they did to the iPhone 5S for the iPhone SE 2 with the iPhone 8, meaning they're gonna use an iPhone 8 style body and update the internals there and also sell this phone at a much lower cost than any of Apple's other phone offerings. I'm talking like $400 low, because Apple stopped selling the iPhone SE at around $349. It initially came out in March 2016 at $399, and then they currently sell the iPhone 8 for $449. So I think right smack in the middle, at about $399, $400 is where this iPhone SE 2 could really take a ton of market share and make a lot of people happy. The reason that I'm excited for this phone is because it's not going to be essentially worse than the other phones. Like, yes, the materials are gonna be a little bit cheaper, and it's going to have an LCD screen, and it is going to be the smallest screen size and non-all screen device that Apple offers, but it's going to have an insanely fast processor. It's said to be the A13 chip, which if you're playing along at home is the same processor that Apple uses in not only the iPhone 11, but also the iPhone 11 Pro and the iPhone 11 Pro Max. It means that you are going to get the fastest possible performance in the new iPhone SE for a much lower cost than all of Apple's other iPhones. Will that cannibalize the sales of those models? I don't exactly know. But another benefit of that that's not outlined in the report, I believe, is going to be significantly better battery life. Apple, through the A13 processor, especially on the iPhone 11 Pro, had these insane like 4 hour generation over generation battery performance gains. So I think we'll see at least something subtle on this lower cost iPhone. It's also said to have 3 gigabytes of RAM. So again, not slacking there. For me, the biggest question is what Apple's gonna do with the camera module. Will they flex on us and add a dual camera module like the iPhone 11? I don't think so. I think Apple's gonna go lowest cost here. So even if it can shoot like amazing photos, I think Apple's gonna go with one standard wide angle lens, no telephoto, no ultra wide, just to give you some really great image quality with the A13 chip and iPhone 11 camera module, but without the complexity and cost of 2 or 3 additional lenses on here. Now, obviously, because we're a few months away from March 2020, we don't have any actual hands-on images just yet or official renders, but we're hearing it's gonna be inside of an iPhone 8 body, and well, I got an iPhone 8 right there on the screen behind me. I reviewed the iPhone 8 a few years ago. I used the iPhone 8 for a long time. It was a really great phone. I just prefer the larger 5.8 inch screen of an iPhone 10 style device. So that's why I use one of those over an older iPhone 8. Looking at the big picture here though, this could easily become, and I think easily become, the best value phone on the market. If you're getting the fastest processor in any smartphone for under $500, that's a pretty ridiculous proposition. And I know people like my mom who've been holding on to their iPhone 6s and 7s, even iPhone 8s, have been looking to upgrade, but say, yeah, $700 and a new design and no home button, nah, I don't really know about that. And you go, oh gosh, $1,000, I don't know about that, Jimmy. Like a much bigger group of people that don't just want a smaller iPhone, want a cheaper iPhone that is also really good. And Apple just hasn't offered that in a long time. So this could be the comeback. And we know Apple stock has been struggling a little bit. We know they haven't been selling as many iPhones. I think this would be a great way to supplement the lack of sales on the most expensive models by offering a semi-premium yet affordable iPhone 8 style device. And of course, that also means you're gonna be getting an LCD screen, 4.7 inches diagonally, and Touch ID rather than Face ID. So again, for everybody else saying, I miss Touch ID, I want it to come back, well, Apple's gonna be coming out with this phone and they're certainly not gonna flex that hard and introduce Face ID because that would raise the component cost by a significant amount. So let me know what your thoughts are down below. I know the rumors for the iPhone SE have been crazy. We thought it was gonna come and then not, and then come and then not, and come and not, you know, forever. But I really think, because Minchi Ko has put his name on it, I also think Bloomberg has been talking about this device. I really think this time it's finally gonna happen. So drop a like if you enjoyed this video, hit subscribe for more. That's all I got for you. And I'll talk to you guys on my sick iPhone SE 2. I wonder what Apple's gonna call it. I don't really know, but it's gonna be really good either way. So see you guys later.